5 m square, by differential one more time, power go in front, this is 20 x to the power of 3. So if I keep differentiating, eventually this is dq y dx cube, that's power go in front, 60 x power 2. So after that, eventually if we differentiate enough time, by the time if I reach d6y dx power 6, this will give me the value 0. Eventually we have 5. Yeah, so if m in general, if you differentiate a sufficient number of times polynomials, you will get 0. Okay, so this was one of the things that was tested, but not tested, asked of you later on. So just to go through question 3.1, if the polynomial function of degree m, the n derivative is always 0 if n is more than m. Okay, so for example, if the function of degree m is y equals to x power n. Okay, so the degree is the highest power. Okay, so if I keep differentiating, for example, this is fx, by the time I reach f prime, f double prime, f triple prime, if I reach until a point where I reach n, which what we call the n derivative, okay, the n derivative, then definitely this will give me 0. Okay, just like just now, when I differentiate up to 6, you can see 6 is more than 5, right? Okay, every time I differentiate, the degree drops by 1. Power 5 becomes power 4, power 4 becomes power 3, 3 becomes 2, 2 becomes 1, 1, 1, 1 becomes 0. Okay, can I? Then after that, we did question 3.3. Question 3.3, I just want to talk about a bit. Okay, so because quite a few have some trouble understanding what's the intention of the question. Now, when asked to show, right, we cannot assume equality. What you do is you start from the left hand side. Okay, definitely looking at these two players, right, you know that d2y dx square has to be done by you. Dy dx, and you can't find d2y dx square without first finding dy dx. Okay, so sometimes I just tell students, if you see a differentiation question, when in doubt, just differentiate. You should get some marks. Okay, so if you find dy dx, a lot of you were looking at this and you do not know what to do. So you need to consider that you don't really need quotient rule. Okay, you don't really need quotient rule because I can easily write this. I can easily write this as your y. You can easily write it as 2 minus x power negative 1. You don't need quotient rule. So some of you use quotient rule, right? Because it's like, you know, we being Singaporeans, if they follow the rules, follow the rules. If you don't follow the rules, you cannot find. Okay? But you also keep your mind open, okay? So you don't have to use the quotient rule. That's the chain rule. Okay? Yeah, and if you differentiate this, I'll go in front, this should be your d2y dx square. So all you need to do, right, is to take y and d2y dx square. If you take the two rates, you're going to get the left hand side. 2dy dx square, that is the right hand side. Okay, you will get this also. Fair enough, right? So you can see that again, these two. They are equal. Okay, this one is equal. Okay, because both are power 4, power 4. Can I? Okay, have you all done this part? All done this part? All have your notes on the all got bring your notes? Anyone have a bring? Okay, so with that, I will start on stationary point. Okay? I know a lot of you are already at stationary point, so help me to copy the first part. So to today we have part 4, which is on stationary coil.
If you look at stationary point, the derivative changes sign.
What do I mean by the derivative trainer side? So what you observe is as you go around, let's say this one. Okay, do you notice that for a maximum point, right? Here, the tangent is this way, so it's like a positive. At this point, the gradient is zero. And here, if I go downwards, the gradient is negative. You realize that? So for a maximum point, the gradient, the tangent goes up, zero, down. It's like a positive, zero, negative. Meaning the sign of the gradient is positive, zero, negative. So far, okay? Quite logical. What about minimum point? If you draw the tangent around the minimum point, negative, zero, positive. Again, you can see that the derivative changes sign. The derivative changes sign. Okay, negative, zero, positive. Okay, so this is the sign of the derivative. The sign of the derivative. Whereas this is the slope of the tangent. Okay. Slope of the this is the sign. This is the slope. Okay, ma. Now, this, okay, some of you ask what is the meaning of the word local, Local, when we say local means example, Singapore, right now, local Singapore, okay. If you are the best in Singapore, does it mean that you are the best in the world? May not be, right now. So, it's the same. If you look at B and D, I just draw two so you can see. B is what we call a local maximum. So, because you can see, it is the highest point, but only in a certain neighborhood. Throughout the whole curve, is it a global maximum? It is not. So B is what we call, is what we call like a local maximum. Local maximum is only big in the constricted neighborhood. Whereas if you look at D, let's say you look at D, D is what we call a global maximum. Okay, not super important. Local, global, not super important. That's for you. Whereas if you look at C, you can also say this is a local minimum. This is a global minimum. Okay, global means throughout the whole curve. This is indeed the global spot. So far, okay? Okay, do you need a copy? If you are copying the graph, you can also take a look at the next page. Okay, try to write down the sign of dy dx as well as the slope of the tangent. Okay, also just help me with it. It shouldn't take you too long, maximum 1 minute. Sorry. Okay. I want to remind a few things. Number one, right? Stationary point for it to exist, listen carefully, is that you must first have gradient to be zero. You must first have a gradient to be zero. Okay, because if the gradient is not zero, right, you will not have any stationary point. So far, okay? Can I? There are some curves, right, which does not have stationary point, right? You know, you realize it's actually very fun. Okay, I'll tell you. For example, y equals to ln x. You take dy dx equals to 1 over x. Can 1 over x ever be 0? Can 1 over x ever be 0? Natalia cannot, right? Because if a over b equals to 0, only if a is equals to 0, right? So if you look at the denominator, it's x, right? It cannot be 0. And that's why if you look at long graph, it's like always like this. It will never be 0. Nice, right? So you can see that this one has no turning points. It has no turning points. There really no turning point. Okay, huh? Okay, now. What about example? Example, y equals to e power x. The dy dx is also e power x, right? Can e power x ever be zero? Can E power 7 be 0? Also cannot. Also, there are some of these very beautiful graphs that cannot ever be 0. Can never be 0. Okay, huh? And so that's for your info. Okay? So, yeah. Then, okay, for point of inflection, okay, don't just write down point of inflection, write down stationary point of inflection. Because there's also non-stationary. So please help me to write down stationary point of inflection. This what we call the, okay, we don't know if it's global or local. So, and these are those in blue, these are what we call the nature. Okay, these are what we call the nature. What's your nature? Are you a kind person or whatever? Okay, so you're describing the character of the point. What is it? Okay, she's 16 years old, she's tall, this is it. So you're describing this. It's a minimum point. It's a maximum, it's a minimum, or it's a point, stationary point question. When the question asks for nature, you need to write these three. Okay, man? Question will always ask for nature. Everything about stationary point question, they always ask for nature. Okay, and differentiation is also a topic in both H1 and H2 math. So I guarantee you, next year at this time, you also will learn this topic. Okay, in fact, it's a revisit. Okay, huh? You will go through this topic again. In H2 math, application of differentiation is the same. Maximum, minimum, stationary point of differentiation. The only thing is you differentiate more difficult things. Okay, you differentiate inverse function, you differentiate a power x. Okay. So now I come to this hall. Okay, first one, take note of the signs plus 0 minus positive 0 negative. Take note of the sign of dydx, negative 0 positive. Okay? For maximum and minimum point, the tangent you see, the sign of dydx will change. Okay? The sign of dydx will change. Either from positive to negative or negative to positive. Okay, man? So because it's moving up, it goes changes direction. Okay? Moving up is making a U-turn or an N-turn. But for point of inflection, it does not change. Positive, 0, positive again. Negative, 0, negative again. Okay, man? Okay, so just think of how you do. At least for now, you should have a rough idea in your head. If I tell you, hey, can you draw to me a maximum point, you can tell me something like that. Okay, or minimum point, something like that. Point inflection, something like that. Okay, go, stop, go again. Okay, on same direction. So now I will go through this part. Okay, so state the values or the range of values for which the graph is stationary and state the nature of each point. Okay, a lot of you just stop at this 2, 5, 7. So you all literally just wrote this. So you all must help me, help yourself. When you read that question, as I've said before, every one word is $1 million. Okay, sometimes how you read in lesson, then in the quiz also, you also read the same. You just bounce through it very good. Then you all must remember, sometimes, okay, we are all guilty of reading too fast. Okay, when we miss out certain information. Alright, so state the nature. You cannot just ignore this part. Okay, I went around and see quite a lot of people ignore the nature part. You have to do it in the top part. Sorry. So we need to describe this. Stationary point inflection, maximum point, minimum point. Okay, man? Can also help me to make sure that you write it down. Write it down. So part 2, where the graph is increasing, there will be this portion in red, this portion in red as well, and that's basically where x is more than 7, x is more than 4 and less than 5, x is between 3 and 4, x is just less than 2, and these are all the different answers. Oh, sorry, 2, not 3. Between 2 and 4. Okay? For those in red, that's the increasing part. You can see that the graph is going upwards. Okay, I'll give you about 3 minutes. What do you do with the 3 minutes? You think through this part. If you need to, you copy down. Then you chit-chat with your friend a bit. Because the next time I'm going to be the first priority test. That one's important. Okay, so please, you should check. You can stand up, walk around, go for the we have done the first two. We know how to identify stationary point from graph. We know how to look at the three different stationary points. So I'm going to ask someone. Okay, first, can I ask... My question is, what are the three types of stationary points? Shikai. What are the three types? Shikai. Help me choose a person to answer. So what are the three types of stationary point? Minimum point of okay, good. Okay. Now I'm going to go through first of all from the graph, if I give you the graph, you can identify, right? Easy, right? Okay. But what if I just give you the algebraic function? So for example, what if in your question you don't have the graph and you like me, I'm very lousy at drawing graph, I just want to do it from here. From here I want to identify my stationary point. Then what do I do? So the first thing, right? Okay, what are you doing? Taking booster, you're helping. So you wore a question. Okay, so from here, what you need to do, let me show you something called the first derivative test. Okay, you are also going to use this for A level. So you are using this for the long run. Okay, so take it carefully. Okay, first derivative test goes something like that. Okay, now I have a function y. I need to first identify the nature of the stationary point. So what does it mean by nature of stationary point? I want to ask, can I ask, why am I not asking? Okay, I'll just give you another name. What's the nature of the stationary point? Maximum? Minimum? Reflection? Say the full name. Okay, so here, right, what we want to do is first, remember, what's the first criteria of stationary point? The gradient is equal to 0. So we first find the dy dx. Okay, we equate the dy dx to 0. Equate the dy dx to 0. So first, you notice, the first plan, you find dy dx. Okay? Equate to 0 to find the stationary points. You find that from here, when dy dx equals to 0, your x is equals to 1 or 2. Okay, and you sub it in to find the y coordinate. So this is 1, 1. This is 1, 1. 1, 1. This is 2, 0. But I know that there are stationary points. But what are they? Are they maximum? Are they minimum? Or are they point of reflection? So what do I do next? Is I will start to look at. This is what we call the first derivative test. Now. Please do not copy this part because it is incorrect. Okay, so let me tell you what NJC requires. Okay. So you know this, right? If you do this, right, 1 minus 1 plus is a bit slack. Okay, so what we require, listen carefully, what do we require? We require to put 1. Instead of 1 plus, I need to write 1.01. We go a bit to the right. So what we are doing is actually in the graph, right? I'm testing the value, or I'm finding or testing the value of dy dx in a small neighborhood. A around the stationary point. I'm testing or finding the value of dy dx. Okay, in a small neighborhood around the stationary point. Okay, I know that this part, dy dx is equals to zero. So, I go a bit to the left, maybe this is 1.01. I go a bit to the right, 0.99. So what you need to do, you need to go to, instead of 1 minus, you write 0.99. Okay? Can I? And here, you see this is my dy dx. Instead of minus, you may be substituting and you may get something like maybe negative 0.231, for example. On the left side, you must get a positive value, positive 0.231. Okay, so main thing is you need numerical values. You need numerical values. Okay, for your table. Okay, for table. This is called the first derivative test. Why is it first? Because I only differentiate some one time. Okay, I only differentiate one time. Okay. So far okay, ma? So let me go through in detail. Okay, so you see that how do I find, okay, so let's assume that in this point here, I go a bit to the left, x will be 0.99. I substitute 0.99 into dy dx. So this point here, what I'm doing is I will sub x equals to 0.99 into dy dx. Okay, where is my dy dx? It's here, 6x minus 1, x minus 2. Okay, so dy dx, which is 6x minus 1, x minus 2. This is equals to 6, 0.99 minus 1, 0.99 minus 2. Can anyone help me? So this will be 6 times negative 0.01 times negative 0.02, which is can you help me with this? My decimal operator. It's very clear.
Zero point zero zero one.
So this value is 0.001 and 0.012. And on the right side, what do I do with this part? You sub x equals to 1.01 into dy dx. Okay, so that is, which is dy dx is 6 of x minus 1, x minus 2. Now you have 6 of 1.01 minus 1, 1.01 minus 2. So far okay? So this is your 1.01. Okay, ma? This is the x. Okay, you are testing the dy dx in a small neighborhood. Okay, ma, you are testing the dy dx in a small neighborhood. Okay, ma. So, again, what's the value? This will be 6 times 0.01 times 8. Hey, sorry, I didn't miss that. Can someone let me a copy of it then? 6 times. These two, right, you notice you need numerical values for the table. OK? Okay, Mark, you need numerical values for the table. Please make sure that you have numerical values for the table. Not this kind, huh? This kind cannot. This kind cannot. Okay? Yes. Yes, you need to draw a table. Okay, you need to draw a table. So, very simple, it's a 3x4 table. 3 rows, 4 columns. Okay, you draw a 3x4 table. Okay, you draw a 3x4 table. So what you do, remember, key things to take note for first derivative test. For first derivative test, you draw a 3x4 table. Okay, number two, okay, you sub values in. You sub values that are so-called plus minus 0.01 of the stationary point. Okay. And so I hope you can follow this example and you can do question 4.4. You can do question 4.4. Okay, huh? Okay. Similarly, for this graph, I'm not going to use 2 minus, I'm going to use the value 1.99. I'm not going to use the value 2 plus. I'm going to use the 2.01. Okay? Same for this side. Just make sure you are okay with this portion. For first derivative test, make sure you learn properly because it's going to last you for quite long. Till the day you stop doing math. Okay? Till the day you stop doing math. Yes? done talking, then you know, right? Once you pay a lot of points, I know I can go on.
If this is increasing, d2y dx squared is positive.
Cannot. That's why for minimum point, second derivative is positive. So what about this part? Okay, let's say where can stop touch that? Then give me a value. Negative. What do you see? 10. Oh, very good. Okay, 10. Okay, next one. See that? See after the hour? 8. Should I? 10, 8, 6. Okay, you choose? 2. Here? Here? 0. Joshua? 2. Oh, 92. Are we sure? 95, okay, negative 7, negative 10. Now look at the values. Can you see that dy/dx is decreasing? Can you see your dy/dx is decreasing? It's decreasing. As x increases, dy/dx increases. Time out. So imagine if I draw, same theory, if I draw x versus dy/dx, right? Your dy/dx is going down. What's the gradient of dy/dx? Okay. Can you see dy/dx square is less than 0. That's why a maximum point is negative. Okay, I will stop here. I'll continue tomorrow. Thank you. Okay.